Laird's Training here. I'm going to do a video today on high-level pitching, high-level throwers, high-velocity throwers. It encapsulates all these type of athletes because they're the same type of athletes. For some reason, in 2017, there's still this misconception, and people don't understand, whether it's parents, athletes, coaches, and even high-level coaches at prestigious universities, they don't understand all these key points that make a high-level thrower, and a healthy high-level thrower. So I'm going to outline these. Now, being a former Division I baseball player, being a strength athlete, strength training since I was 14 years old, currently as a strength coach and a baseball coach, I work with high-level athletes, I work with intermediate-level athletes, even beginner-level athletes. I love working with all type of athletes. Now, coaching, when it comes to baseball, I'm coaching high-level athletes in the Indiana Bulls organization. I love doing it because I get to work with kids and help them achieve goals, help them see what they need to learn for the next level, and prepare them for that next level. Now, saying that, all these type of athletes have one thing in common that perform high at a high level. They work hard and have a blue-collar work ethic. Now, saying that, that's going to be the foundation of this video, okay? That work ethic is so important for these six things I'm going to outline here. What are these six key points? Strength and power, arm care and arm strength, running, long toss, mechanics, and recovery. I'm going to describe and go into detail on each one of these key points. Before I do that, you need to understand that if you want to be a top-level guy, a high-level thrower, you need to be implementing all six of these key points into your program. If you are not, don't sit there and talk about a big game about wanting to be a top-notch guy because you're not doing the right things to be a top-notch guy. Everybody wants to quote, oh, I'm working hard, I'm doing the right things in the weight room, I'm doing my long toss, I'm busting my butt. Here's the reality of things. Everybody that usually says those things aren't doing it, because the guys that really are doing those things don't need to be saying that stuff on social media and saying that stuff out loud to other people to make themselves believe and make them say, validate themselves of what they're really doing. So let's get into this. Strength and power. First and foremost, a lot of guys have genetics for this, okay? They already have a natural predisposition to be able to throw hard, okay? They're naturally strong, they're naturally powerful. But just like in anything in life, you can work hard and train your body to maximize your ability. So, what is strength and power? Where does that come from? Well, it's core stability, right? It's being able to develop power and display power on the field, in the weight room, wherever we're going. Now, in this, it's on the mound. So, how do we develop strength and power? We got to get in the weight room. We got to train the right way. We got to be doing sprinting, okay? Speed work, dynamic effort work in the weight room. We got to be being explosive. Metabolic power training, we've got to be able to understand that power comes from the ground up. We've got to display that power from the ground up and a rotational factor when it comes to pitching, okay? And like I said before, genetics. Those are the main key points to develop that strength and power. If you're not lifting, if you're not training in the weight room, you're behind the eight ball. Number two, arm care and arm strength. This includes weight room, training the upper back in the weight room, getting that mobility in the weight room, making sure we're strong and don't have a weak point. Band work, which you should be doing as part of your prehab in the weight room, but most importantly, on the field, before you throw, after you throw for recovery protocols, which we're going to talk about later. Also, mobility, okay? Do you have a natural scapular function? Do you have the scapular mobility and the scapular stability to be able to implement the weight room program effectively, right, without any kind of flaws in your body, mechanically, basically being efficient with your body? Are you working on these things, okay? Because your body will break down if you're not doing these things. You can also throw a long toss on here. Weighted balls are popular nowadays. Weighted balls are part of arm care and arm strength if they're implemented properly. Now, number three, running. Now, this isn't long distance running. I'm not an advocate for long distance running. I think long distance running is a joke for pitchers. Not saying that we can't train aerobically, okay? But I believe in training anaerobically. I believe in training in interval sprints. As a pitcher, you're a power athlete. Okay? As a baseball player, you're a power athlete. We've got to develop power and what I call speed endurance over and over and over and be able to display that power over and over and over. You want to be able to throw 105 pitches in a game and be just as strong as you are in the seventh inning as you are in the first inning? You have to be doing this. Now, if my legs aren't working, okay? If my legs are tired, am I going to be able to display that power? The answer is no. Okay? I have to be implementing this running because you are only as strong as your weakest link. Okay? The body's a chain. If I'm pulling on a chain and one of those links on that chain is broken, it's gonna break, okay? The body's the same way. So, running, speed work, sprint work, interval training. I'll do a video in the future about the importance of what type of running for pitchers, but a perfect example, you can look up Eric Cressy, who's a well-known and well-renowned strength coach. He talks about the importance of sprint work and not doing the aerobic type of running. Again, sprints, I'll talk about that again, and intervals. All I have my pitchers do when it comes to training, we do a lot of Tabata type intervals. We do a lot of sprint work with prowlers. We do a lot of hill sprints. We're developing that power. We're getting strong as hell in the weight room, but also strong when we're doing this type of conditioning. Not to say that the conditioning doesn't have its place, but if you want to be a powerful pitcher and be able to implement that power over and over and over, that's the type of running you need to be doing. Number four, long toss. Again, we can throw that same thing with arm carry and arm strength, but I wanted to keep these separate. The reason I wanted to keep these separate is because too many people leave out the bands. That's why I wanted to have that separate. The bands of mobility, so important. Long toss. Now, there's different types of long toss. You've got to go on how you feel. The Jaeger long toss program, phenomenal. It's stuff that I implement with my guys. You go on how you feel for that day. You don't have to go all out 100% and try to show off. Also, if you are mechanically deficient and inefficient with your mechanics, meaning if I get out to 270 feet and I'm flying my front side, I'm getting my arms dropping, I'm sagging through, that's not efficiently working. That's like getting a barbell and going like this when I'm doing my bench press, okay? You're not helping yourself, okay? When you're doing your long toss, implement it properly. You're doing it for arm care, arm strength, and also you're doing it when you're getting out to that extension phase and you're getting that high arc. You're also working on the flexibility and mobility and the nice fluid motion, tempo, and rhythm of your delivery and when you're throwing. You're learning to utilize your entire body when you're utilizing long toss, which you want to utilize when you're on the mound as well. Can't stress the importance of this enough, especially when it comes to developing younger athletes in the early teens and maintaining your ability as a high-level athlete when you get older. Mechanics, the fifth key point. If I do not have a flow, if I do not have tempo and rhythm in my delivery, there's a problem. Okay, just like with hitting, we want to have nice, good timing, okay? Hitting is timing, pitching is disrupting timing. Now, saying that pitching is disrupting timing for the hitters, we still have to have our own timing and rhythm and flow when we're delivering, okay? In our delivery. I don't want to have any deficiencies. I don't want to be pulling my front side. I don't want to have weakness in my core or flexibility weaknesses, okay? Understand, again, when I was talking about the running, if my legs are tired, my mechanics aren't going to be there, okay? If I'm not strong enough to be able to pitch 6-7 innings and go into 95 pitches as a pitch limit, depending on what level or what age you are, you're going to fall apart. No deficiencies, no pulling the front side, no arm drag, no arm. You want to make sure that you are optimizing your delivery and want to make sure that you are completing the delivery with efficient power and efficient mechanics. Again, all these factors, these other five factors have a reason and implement the mechanics. You're not going to have good mechanics if you're not implementing long toss. You're not going to have good mechanics if you're not running. You're not going to have good mechanics if you're not doing your arm carry arm strength. You're not going to have good mechanics if you have no core stability, no strength. It is what it is. Now, you're not going to have good mechanics for the last point, recovery. And this is even more important the older that you get. Now, why did I leave recovery last? Because what is a part of recovery? Well, mechanics is a part of recovery. Working on the right mechanics, making sure that I'm implementing and fixing any faults and weak points in my delivery. Long toss is a part of recovery, right? Running, that's a part of my recovery. Arm carry and arm strength, that's part of my recovery. Strength and power, training in the weight room, busting my ass in the weight room, that's part of my recovery. What else is a part of recovery? The most important factors that you can control day in and day out. Nutrition and sleep. Am I eating the right things? Am I taking care of my body so my body recovers? Am I sleeping or am I staying out all night, going to parties and not taking care of my body? And you see right here, arm care, weight room, and running. These are all six factors for high-level pitchers. Now, you can sit there and say, well, I know this guy who's playing in the MLB and pitching in the MLB, and he didn't do any of these things. Well, there are exceptions to every rule. There are freak athletes, and I've known those same freak athletes that could roll out of bed and hit 400. Okay? Those are freak athletes. If you're going to compare yourself to a freak athlete and you think that you can skate by and not do the hard things and not do the actual work like Michael Jordan himself in the NBA did to make him the best, greatest player of all time, good for you. If you're that great, go ahead. We'll see how long you last until your body breaks down. Sooner or later, if you're not doing the right things, the body breaks down, you're not performing as high level as you can. And I'm going to tell you right now, those elite guys that just roll out of bed and do that, yeah, they're awesome. But if they implement these things, they go from elite to legendary status because they're implementing these things all the time. Now, this is my video on high-level pitching, high-velocity throwers. These are the six key points that you need to be implementing if you want to be that guy day in and day out and not just talk the talk, but also walk the walk. Laird's Training, if you like the video, make sure you subscribe. Check out my website in the description below. I'll make sure I put all these in the description below so you can copy and paste them into Word and print them out. Until next time, see you later.